Hello, today I'll be showing you 5 tips before using Protastructure for your design of structures. Okay, so right now, before you must begin to use this software for your design, there are some settings that you are meant to do, and I'll be showing you the 5 tips that you are meant to do before you must begin any structural design using this software, Protastructure. Okay, now the tips number one is design code. So tips number one right now is design code. So before you must begin your design of any structure, even a manual or with any software, you must choose or have in mind the design code you are meant to choose. So right now, to set your design code, even if you didn't set your design code from the earlier stage when you are trying to set up your software, then you can also, after you're done with your modeling, you can also set your design code, okay? So right now, let me assume that we did this design or we did this modeling using your code. And then, all of a sudden, the clients want to build this same type of structures with everything, no changes, let me say, in a country like India. And then you will now have to change the design code from what your code down to Indian code, okay? So by changing your design code, you can change your design code from this place. So the first thing we'll do right now is to come to this icon here that says settings, okay? Now on those settings right now, you will now see this environment. Now on this environment now, you will have to scroll down here and then you will see this place that says code. Now basically it might be on this other side before. Now you have to come here and then choose what codes. Now once you choose code, you will see all the design codes that you have used for the previous design. But if it is the first time that you are modeling the structure, you will see this place as what empty. Okay, so right now if you want to change from one different code to the other, just click on this place that says, you can see that it says concrete design codes. Now if you click on this place now, you will see that we have several codes starting from what the ACI, which is what the American code, as you can see them there, and then the Hong Kong. But right now I want to change from Euro code down to Indian code, okay? So right now I'll just scroll down now and then pick Indian code here, okay? And I'll come here and then come here and then do what and say pick. Automatically right now it will change to Indian code. And the same thing for steel design code. If I want to change my steel design code, I can come here right now, click on this place here, and also choose for my steel design code. Although you can choose two type of code, you can use Indian code for your concrete design and let me see, use either American code, which is the US code, for your steel design, okay? So right now I can come here and choose US code for my steel design, or I come here and choose Euro code or UK. But let me just choose ACI. I'll come here right now and then choose what this code now for my steel design code, okay? And I'll come here and then say pick, okay? Now let's now come for the loading. Now since your main concrete design code is Indian, I would advise you also choose the same country code for your loading, okay? So right now come again right now and then choose my code here, okay? So you can see that I can come here right now and then choose code. Now from this place now you can see that we are not seeing Indian codes here, but I know from the next version that will be coming up, they have said that they will apply Indian codes for their loading, okay? But right now, since there is no Indian codes here, I would advise you use Euro code. That is if you are using Indian codes, okay? But if you're using any other codes and you can find your own codes here for the loading and also for the design, then I would say that you should just pick that, okay? So right now I'll come here and then pick what UK, I'll come here and pick what Euro code here, Euro code one. Okay, and then come here and then pick what pick here, and it will change to what the load, and also same thing here for the wind load here, okay? Now for the wind load now, I'll also come again right now and then pick what Euro code also. Since I have used Euro code for my loading, I'll also choose Euro code for my wind load, okay? So I'll come here right now and then choose the same thing, Euro code here, or you can just also choose different one depending on the code you want to use. So I'll come here and then choose Euro code, and if you want to disable wind load on your structure, just come here and say what, don't use wind load, and you see that it will just go off. And if I say okay right now, the wind load will just go off, okay? But if you want to add wind load, just come here and then check this icon here that said don't use, and then pick on use, and now choose your code, okay? So right now I want to use what, I want to use your code, okay? And I'll come here and then click on what, pick. Setting here for earthquake design load, basically this earthquake design load is basically turned off. That's because it is assumed that most countries does not have earthquake, so they turned it off. So if in case you want to design a any kind of structure in an earthquake region, you come here and then choose what earthquake, and then make sure you turn this off, okay? And then you will be seeing all other codes for earthquake. And I will tell you that for seismic design, the best code for seismic or earthquake design is UO code 8. It is not an argument. You can go and do your research. The design, the best design code for UO code 8 for seismic design or earthquake design is UO code 8. So I would advise you use UO code 8, except you have a deep understanding of all other codes here, then you can choose on that. But if you're a beginner, I would say you should choose UO code 8 for safe purpose. Even professionals still use UO code 8. So I'll come here right now and then choose UO code, and then pick UO code 8, and then come here and say pick, okay? So you can now see how we have set all our design codes based on what I want to do. So this is the number one tips that you are meant to do, is to set your design code, okay? Now, tips number two, the next thing you are going to do is what? Is to set your units. Basically, as you know that there are several units, there are several ways of measuring, like you can use centimeter, you can use metric or imperial and all that. So right now, if you are in a country like Australia that use imperial, feet, inches and all that, you can come here and then pick on this place that says unit here. Okay, so once you pick unit, you can be able to choose different kinds of what unit that you want. Now, these settings are not basically for any, let me say, for a specific country. No, you can be in Nigeria, or you can be in Africa and design a structure for someone in Australia or for someone in India or Asia. So for you to be able to design based on their standards, you must have to come and change all the settings to their standards, and then you will be able to design based on their standard. Let me say, if I'm to design a structure right now for a client in Australia, I will not have to come and use a metric system of measurement because they use imperial. So I'll have to come here right now and then change all my units from metric to imperial, as you can see that. And also change from forces and all that to what you have, okay? So you can come here and then change all, as you can see right now, this is called SI unit, this is called imperial here. So if I come here right now and then choose imperial, and I'll say yes, it will change everything to imperial. As you can see right now, we have now seen what? You can now see inches and feet, as you can see that. And then you can also see for levels, you can see feet and all that. You can choose if you want to use all that. And then also for your forces and load, you can also see all things have not changed to what? Imperial measurement, okay? But if you want to use SI, which is metric, just go here and then click on what? CI, and then say yes, okay? And then you will just navigate to the country standard of the area you are doing your design. So right now, let me assume that I am using metric method, and I want to measure in meters. I'll just come here and then choose meters for my measurement of members, and for my levels, I can come here and choose, let me say, centimeter or the same thing, meters, okay? So this is how you can play with the settings. So make sure you set your units based on the country you are designing for, okay? So right now, I'll just take it back to what? So millimeter, and leave my levels in meter, okay? And then come here, right? And then for your forces right now, you can choose to choose kilonewton or newton based on what you want to use. So the same thing applies to all these other ones here and all that. So right now, once you're done with that, then you are done with your units and format settings. So tips number three right now, tips number three goes to activating your autosave. This is very, very important because Protastructure, most of the times, you might be working on the softwares and maybe your system might just misbehave. And if you have not saved your recent progress, you will lose all what you have done so far. Now, it is very important for you to go and activate what? To go and activate autosave. Basically, this software gives autosave as zero. That means that autosave is not activated. So you must go and then turn on your autosave. And to do that, just come here right now, come to the place that says environment here. And then once you come to this place that says Protastructure environment, you will see this place that says autosave here, this panel here. Now, on this autosave now, you will see that this autosave here is set at 0 minutes. That means that it is not set. And if you can check at the message here, they say autosave option will be disabled when interval is zero. So basically, at default, it is zero. So you must have to set your autosave. So the best thing I'll do right now is to come here and then set my autosave as what? Let me say I want to use 0.5 minutes. That is 30 seconds, okay? So it is said that every 30 seconds that this software should save to save my work progress. That is safer for you guys, because if you don't set this, you will see that you will now begin to do that. Now, if if you want to bring this option that says prompt auto saving, this, if you check this right now, you, once it wants to save, it will show a, it will just show a message and say save, auto, like for you to save. But I will say that this is not really that good, because you'll be seeing messages every time. So just turn this off and then just set here to be 0.5, which is half a minute. Or you can also choose to set it 0.25. That's also okay, which is 15 seconds. Sorry, that's 15 seconds. Yeah. So this is how to set your auto save. It is very, very important for you to do this, okay? Now, tips number four is what is also very, very important, which is choose your display and report language. Now, the same thing I said before, that you can be in Africa or be in Asia and design structure for someone in Europe. Now, the only thing that you have to do is to come and change to their language. Let me say that I am in, Nigeria, Lagos, and I want to design for a building in someone in, Portugal, okay, yeah, Portugal. The next thing I'll do is to come and change my display language to what? I can choose my display language to English, because that is a language I can understand. But when it comes to, for you to now send your design reports, you must not send your design reports with English, because they don't speak English and they don't understand English. So you have to come here that says report language and click on this place and choose the language that you want. You can see that we have several languages, starting from Turkish, Spanish, Romania, Slovenia, and Polish and all that, and then you can come here and then choose Portugal depending on the country you are designing for. So this software has different languages, as you can see right now. So I'll just come here right now and then choose Portugal. So when I'm done with my design, which I am using English for my design, and then when I'm not produced my design reports, even the drawings, it will all carry Portuguese language, okay? That is fine, because that is only language that your clients can understand. So you can be in any country and design for any person in any country, anywhere. But once you follow all these tips and all these settings, starting from the tip number one, design code, and then for the units, and then for the language and all that, okay? So right now we'll now go on to the tips number five. Tips number five simply means project preference. It's very simple, as you can see that project preference, which simply means for it now impute your client's name, the project title and all that. So you can do that right now on this place here. This is tips number four, project preference. As you can see right now, they have for the consultant and they have for the project. So on this place right now, you can see the place that says completed by what. Just come here right now and put your name, which is the design engineer. Right now my name is Justice Mwaka. So I'll come here right now and then put engineer and then put dot justice, okay, Mwaka. Just putting your name here, sorry. Yeah, that's fine. So putting your name designed by, and then putting your controlled by. You can put in your boss name here and put in drawn by. If you're the one that is going to also arrange the those drawings, you can put the same thing as what? Engineer. Okay, putting your name again, same thing again here. And all that. Okay, that's fine. And then you can see that it presented by. If you're the one that's going to present the model to the client, like doing a 3D presentation to the client, you can also put in your name here, the same thing here, just say same, or put in your name again there, and all that, and then come to this place that says what, client's name. On this client's name right now, you are meant to impute your client's name, just as name implies client's name. So I can just come here and put what, come here right now, then put what, Mr. And I can choose to add Mr. John. Yeah, Mr. John. That's fine. And then you can put in the other name. Maybe the son. Let me say Mr. Don Atone. Okay, that's fine. So you can now come again right now and put in the project title, which simply means you can say this building right now is a story 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. But this basically is a school building. Okay, so I can come here right now and say school apartments. Okay, that's fine. And then all that, and then come here right now, then put in your project number. Okay, this project number simply means, since you are the consultant engineer, just put in, you can say if your company name, like me right now, my company name is Ekidel, I can just come here right now and then put Ekidel, or put I can put and put zero or number 100 then / Ekidel. Okay, that's fine. That means that this is the 100 design I am doing this year alone. Okay, that's what it means. Although I have done more than this already. So right now, this place right now that says date, you have to put in the project date. You can choose to click here and choose your date, or just type in the value there. So I can Today is the third of what? Okay, I'll come right now then put third. I can choose to even go and increase the date to further date, okay, and all that. Or even decrease the date if you want to decrease the date, okay. You can choose to do that also and decrease it, okay. Anyhow, you want to do it, that's fine. And then come here right now and then put in the birth address. Let me see that this building is in a country like, let me say, okay, I can choose Canada or let me say India. I'll come here right now and then put what? India and all that. India and all that, okay, that's fine. And then put in the address in India and all that. Then this one right now simply means what? Revision, okay. If this is the first time you are joining this project, let's say revision 1 or revision 0, so revision 0, and if you have issued this plan before to your client and then he now made changes, then now come here and put what? Revision 1. So any number of time he have made changes, that's what you're going to put here as the revision number, okay, that's fine. So this is how to set, or this is the basic 5 steps that you are going to do. Now don't go anywhere, I'll give you again the next step, which is the bonus step. But before then, once you're done with all your settings and all your settings, you are meant to click OK, else it will not work, okay? So always click OK. But right now, I am not designing for anyone in India, so I'll come here right now then, or in Portugal, I'll come here right now and pick up my what, and pick up what, English, back to English, and then I'll come again right now for the unit here. If I let me see here, it's still the same thing, that's fine, and everything is okay. I'll come here right now then click on what here, okay. So once you're done with your settings, make sure you click on what, okay, else what you have done will not save, okay? So make sure you click on okay once you're done with the settings. So right now again, the bonus tips, which is now making your model interface environment very fast, knowing that if you're modeling with this software, you might experience lagging and all that. So to make your model, as it's right now, you can experience lagging based on the way, on the massiveness of your structure or your model. So to make your design or your model process very, very fast, the first thing you do is to go and then activate your settings, okay? Go to settings here and you will see this display that says performance mode. Basically, it is always turned off. Now, when it's turned off like this, you can see that you might be experiencing lagging. Let me say you want to insert beam and it will take longer time for it to show dialog box and all that. But once you activate this right now that says performance mode, you will now see that everything will be very, very fast on your model. Although most of your things will not be showing light, like the text will be showing light and all that, but it will help you a lot when you are modeling a very massive structure. So right now, if I come here right now and then turn on this right now and then wait for it to now activate, you just hold on and then wait for a while, you will see that it is there. You see that this is your model right now very, very, very fast. So once you turn this on, you will now be experiencing fast modeling, okay? You can see that it is not turned on and all that, and we can see that now it is not very, very fast. Now if I can turn it off right now, I am saying that I don't want it to be very, very fast and all that. I'll just turn it off right now. So to make your modeling stage very, very, very fast, just turn it on, and then when you're done with your modeling, then now go here and then turn it off. Okay, that's fine. So this is the basic 5 steps that you are meant to do before you must use the software for your design, okay? The tip number 1 is simply what? Choosing your design code. And tip number 2 is what? Setting your units. And number 3 is turning on your autosave. And number 4 is choosing your display language and your report language. And the tip number 5 is what? Is set your project preference. And for the bonus one is to activate or making your model very fast. So once you apply these 5 tips, then you are good to go in using the software for your modeling. Although there are other tips for the loading and all that, but that will come up in the next video. Stay tuned and then see you again right now. So if this is the first time on Ekidel, I would say you should click on the subscribe button and give this video a thumbs up. Thank you so much and bye for now.